నమస్కారం. డాక్టర్ బిఆర్ అంబేద్కర్ సార్వత్రిక విశ్వవిద్యాలయం విద్యార్థిని విద్యార్థులకు స్వాగతం. ఈనాటి కార్యక్రమంలో
హలో స్టూడెంట్స్, టుడే వీ షాల్ ట్రై టు డిస్కస్ అండ్ అండర్స్టాండ్ ప్రైస్ అండ్ అవుట్పుట్ డిటర్మినేషన్ అండర్ పర్ఫెక్ట్ కాంపిటీషన్. దిస్ టాపిక్ ఈజ్ ఎ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ యువర్ మేనేజరియల్ ఎకనామిక్స్ కోర్స్ ఆఫ్ ఫస్ట్ ఇయర్ ఎంబీఏ. వీ ఆల్ నో దట్ ద మార్కెట్ స్ట్రక్చర్స్, ఇన్ ద సెన్స్ బేసికల్లీ ద కమోడిటీ అండ్ సర్వీస్ మార్కెట్స్ హ్యావ్ బీన్ క్లాసిఫైడ్ ఇన్ టు డిఫరెంట్ టైప్స్, నేమ్లీ పర్ఫెక్ట్ కాంపిటీషన్ అండ్ ఇంపర్ఫెక్ట్ కాంపిటీషన్, based on certain conditions or characteristics such as the existence of number of buyers and sellers for a particular product, and at the same time whether the product produced by business firms is identical, that is to say homogeneous or not, and further by taking into account whether the business firms producing the commodities resort to advertising expenditures, that is to say promotional expenditures or publicity expenditures or not. By taking into account these characteristics or the features, already I stated commodity markets and service markets have been classified under perfect competition and imperfect competition. The main objective of today's lecture is to discuss and understand the meaning of perfect competition, the characteristics of perfect competition, the price determination under perfect competition, the output determination under perfect competition, and finally the summary. At the outset, we pose ourselves a question: what do you mean by perfect competition? In general usage, competition implies rivalry. In the sense, there is rivalry among individual business firms. But whereas in market terminology, competition is perfect implies there exists complete harmony among the business firms. In the sense, we can define perfect competition in terms of saying that perfect competition is a market structure characterized by the complete absence of rivalry or the existence of harmony among the individual business firms. Now we try to understand the basic features of perfect competition. The first and foremost feature of perfect competition, that is, there exists large number of buyers and sellers for a particular product. Take into account any commodity, and at the same time you try to observe the presence of buyers and sellers for that particular product. If you observe that there exists millions of buyers and millions of sellers for a particular product, such as agricultural products, vegetables for example, or paddy for example, wheat etc., then immediately you can say that commodity falls under the gambit of perfect competition. But the important thing here is, what is the consequence of the presence of millions of buyers and sellers for a particular product? The basic consequence is, in such a market where neither a single buyer nor a single seller can influence the price with their independent actions or with their own actions, under these conditions the price in such a market is determined by the forces of demand and supply, and basically the equality between the demand for the commodity and supply of the commodity, that determines, that gives us the equilibrium price. Here, what is the demand side? Basically, where do we get the demand? The demand comes from the buyer's side. Supply means it is the sellers. So the force, the equality between the forces of demand and the supply, that determine the equilibrium price. In such a market, what is the role of a business firm in the determination of price? Here, under perfect competition, individual business firm is a price taker. Individual business firms with their own actions cannot influence the price. So they have to accept the price determined by the total demand and the total supply, that is the equality between total demand and total supply. That is to say, the price under perfect competition is determined by the industry. What is industry? Industry means group of firms producing homogeneous product. So, under perfect competition, there exists large number of buyers and sellers, and the price is determined by the equality between the total demand for the product and total supply. As a result, individual business firms cannot influence the price with their own actions. Now, the second characteristics of perfect competition, the presence of homogeneous product or identical product. Though there exist millions of business firms, all business firms produce identical product, where a consumer cannot make a distinction between the product produced by X business firm, Y business firm, Z business firm, etc. All products look alike. And third characteristics, free mobility of factors of production. In the sense, factors of production, particularly capital and labor, can move from one place to another place, one business firm to another business firm, wherever they expect higher reward. In the sense, there are no restrictions on the mobility of factors of production under perfect competition. And fourth characteristics, free entry and exit of business firms. This condition basically applicable in the long run and not in the short run. So, in the short run, under perfect competition, the number of business firms operating or by producing a commodity will remain constant, whereas in the long run, suppose in the short run, if the existing business firms are earning profit, attracted by the profit, new business firms can enter the market. In the same way, in the short run, for example, if the existing business firms are incurring losses, some of the business firms which are not financially sound may leave the industry. In the sense, in the long run, this exit and also entry may take place, but in the short run, the number of business firms operating under perfect competition will remain constant. And fifth characteristic, availability of information. Information in the sense is nothing but perfect knowledge on the part of buyers and also sellers. What is this knowledge related to? Basically, it is related to the price. What was the price yesterday? What is the price today? What will be the price tomorrow? In the same way, what was the demand? What is the demand? What would be the likely demand? In the same way, the supply of the commodity. What was the supply yesterday? What is the supply today? What would be the likely supply? In the sense, the participating agents under perfect competition, they are fully aware of the market conditions. In the sense, they will have the perfect knowledge regarding the market conditions. And sixth and also the last characteristic of perfect competition is the absence of transport cost. Why there is absence of transport cost under perfect competition? Because under perfect competition, the price of a product, irrespective of the geographic location, will remain the constant. Take for example, X commodity. In Delhi, the price of the product 100 rupees. In Hyderabad also, it should be 100 rupees. In Kolkata also, it should be 100 rupees. So, in order to maintain the same price throughout the market, the business firms simply ignore transport costs. And we try to understand now the price determination in the short run. Already I stated the total demand for the product and the total supply of the product, that too equality between these two will determine the equilibrium price, where DD is the demand line and SS is the supply line. The equality at point E, DD intersected the supply line, so that is the equilibrium point, or you can say it is a market clearing point. What do you mean by market clearing point? Where demand is equal to supply, there is no excess supply, there is no shortage of the commodity. So, that P4 is the equilibrium price, that is determined by the industry. We should remember that under perfect competition, the price is determined by the industry, and the individual business firms have no role to play in the determination of the price. We can also see the nature of average revenue and also marginal revenue lines under perfect competition. In simple, we can say the price, since it is determined by the industry, given the demand and given the supply, it remains constant. As a result, the average revenue and also the marginal revenue will remain constant. They are one and the same. In the first column, that is quantity 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 like that, and price, we assumed it as 10 rupees, in the sense price per unit is 10 rupees. So, if your business firm sell 1 unit of a commodity, the total revenue is 10 rupees. How do we get 10 rupees? Just quantity multiplied with the price yields the total revenue. And average revenue, how do you get the average revenue? Total revenue divided by quantity. In the same way, marginal revenue, what is marginal revenue? It is the additional revenue derived by a business firm by selling 1 unit of a commodity, 1 additional unit of a commodity. Or in other words, we can say marginal revenue is the change in total revenue as a result of selling an additional unit of a commodity. By going through the table, it is possible to understand the change in total revenue and also the average revenue and also marginal revenue. Total revenue is increasing at the same rate. Why total revenue increasing at the same rate or same proportion? Because the price remains constant. Price is determined by the industry and not by the business firm. In the same way, average revenue remains constant and marginal revenue also remains constant. We can plot this numerical information on a two-dimensional graph by taking into account output on x-axis, average revenue and marginal revenue on y-axis, and that horizontal line shows average revenue is equal to marginal revenue, that is also equal to price, because once the price remains constant, the average revenue is equal to price and marginal revenue also equal to price, so that under perfect competition, average revenue is equal to marginal revenue is equal to price. Now, we try to understand the output determination. Already I stated, price is determined by the industry and individual business firms have no role to play in the determination of price. But when it comes to output determination, it is by the business firms and not by the industry. By accepting the price determined by the industry, individual business firms have the discretion, have the choice to determine their level of output. How much a business firm can produce, it all depends on its decision and not imposed by the industry. Only thing is, there may be millions of business firms, but all business firms have to accept the price determined in the industry. By accepting that price and also by taking into account its cost of production, each and every business firm can determine, can take a decision related to the level of output. But here the important thing is, the business firms, while taking a decision related to equilibrium output, they follow two conditions, or they have to satisfy two conditions. The first condition is, they always look at marginal cost and marginal revenue, and they compare marginal cost with marginal revenue. So, the first condition is, they always try to equate marginal cost is equal to marginal revenue in order to decide the level of output. And the second condition, marginal cost line or marginal cost curve should cut the MR line from below, in the sense at the point of equilibrium output, the marginal cost must increase and also at the same time, the marginal cost must be more than the marginal revenue. So long as marginal cost decreases, business firms never attain equilibrium. They try to produce larger and larger volumes of output. Once the marginal cost curve, basically it is U-shaped cost curve, and initially as the volume of output increases, the marginal cost decreases, it reaches to a minimum point, and after that, beyond a level of output, the marginal cost increases. So, when the marginal cost increases, then only the business firms attain equilibrium, and particularly when the marginal cost curve, that is the U-shaped marginal cost curve, cuts the marginal revenue line, which is parallel to horizontal axis, at that intersecting point, the business firms attain equilibrium. So, the first condition MC is equal to MR, and the second condition the marginal cost curve should cut the MR line from below. And in the graph at point R1, the marginal cost curve intersected the MR line from below, so that the business firms producing Q2 volume of output, even corresponding to Q1 level of output, MC curve intersecting, cutting the MR line from above. But here the important thing is, after point R, the MR actually lies below the, after cutting the MR line, the MC curve lies below the MR line. That indicates what? MC is less than MR. So that the, as long as MC lies below MR, the business firms will expand volume of output. So, at point R1, the business firms attain equilibrium, and at point R1, MC is not only equal to MR, but also MC curve is cutting the MR line from below, so that the business firms will decide the equilibrium level of output. But here the important thing is, just by attaining equilibrium, there is no guarantee that the business firms will earn maximum profit. It all depends on the existing conditions in the economy. Whether the economy is looking up, in the sense whether there are boom conditions or prosperity conditions in the economy, or recessionary conditions are there, or depressionary conditions, or economic depression is there in the economy. These economic conditions will determine the profit, the nature of profit, in the sense whether the business firms earn maximum profit or normal profit, or the business firms aim at loss minimization, etc. Now, I try to understand the output determination with maximum profit. In the sense, if the objective of the business firm is maximum profit, and the existing economic conditions are also helpful to the business firm, in the sense the economy is looking up, there are boom conditions or prosperity conditions in the economy, there is lot of demand for the commodity, under these conditions the business firms operating under perfect competition, that too in the short run can maximize profit, can earn maximum profit. Maximum profit means under what conditions, or what is the basic condition for earning maximum profit, where the price determined by the industry, if it is more than the average cost, in the sense price greater than average cost, or for the sake of understanding, where already we know that average revenue is equal to marginal revenue is equal to price. So, once price greater than average cost, in the sense price is equal to average revenue, so that average revenue greater than average cost, under these conditions the business firms operating under perfect competition in the short run can earn maximum profit. In the graph we have shown that where the basic condition for equilibrium remain the constant, that is MC is equal to MR, and MC curve should cut the MR line from below. This is so at point R1. So, the business firm operating under perfect competition in the short run determine the level of output, that is the equilibrium level of output corresponding to point R1, so that the business firm, each and every business firm, is producing Q5 level of output. Here we have taken into account a representative business firm. Already we know that perfect competition means there exists millions of suppliers, millions of business firms, but we cannot evaluate, we cannot analyze the behavior of all the business firms or the output decisions of all the business firms. We try to examine the behavior of a representative business firm, and thereby we can generalize the results. So, here in this case, this particular business firm is producing Q5 level of output corresponding to point R1, where point R1 is the equilibrium point, where MC is equal to MR, and also MC curve intersected the MR line from below. As a result, the business firm attained equilibrium. Now, the important question is, though the business firm produced Q5 level of output, whether the business firm is able to earn maximum profit or not. In order to earn profit, how to calculate profit? Profit is equal to total revenue minus total cost. If total revenue exceeds total cost, we can say there is some positive amount of profit. And further, we can also understand the concept of profit by comparing average cost and also average revenue. According to this graph, here at Q5 level of output, average revenue is equal to Q5R1, average cost is equal to Q5R2. See, take into account the difference between average revenue and average cost, where average revenue Q5R1, average cost Q5R2, difference Q5R1 minus Q5R2, that is R1R2, is the profit per unit. So, this particular business firm is able to earn profit per unit to the extent of R1R2. Now, we have to identify the total profit. How do you get the total profit? Total profit we can identify by multiplying total quantity with profit per unit. Here total quantity is OQ5, average profit is Q5R1, so that the total profit is equal to P3, P4, R1, R2, that area is equal to total profit. Now, there is no guarantee that the business firms will earn maximum profit under all conditions. If there is recession in the economy, the business firms end up by earning normal profits, where average revenue is equal to average cost. And in the same way, there is no guarantee that the business firms earn normal profit. If there is depression in the economy, the business firms end up with loss, but the objective of the business firm here is minimization of the loss, where the business firm always tries to equate average variable cost with the price. So, where average variable cost is equal to price, there the business firm will produce. Otherwise, if the average variable cost is less than the price, the business firm will simply stop the production. That is called as shutdown point. And in the long run, all business firms under perfect competition will earn only normal profits, where long run average revenue is equal to average cost is equal to marginal cost is equal to marginal revenue. And further, one important thing is, under perfect competition, in the long run, all the business firms and industry as a whole will operate at the minimum point of the long run average cost. That is to say, all business firms and industry as a whole operate at optimum level, so that all business firms and industry as a whole will earn normal profit in the long run. Summary: perfect competition implies absence of rivalry among the business firms, and at the same time, under perfect competition, there exist millions of buyers and sellers, and equilibrium price is determined by the industry, and firm is a price taker. Firms take output decisions. In the short run, the business firms, taking into account the existing conditions, can maximize profit, can earn normal profit, and sometimes they try to minimize the loss. And in the long run, only normal profit is possible. And in the long run, all business firms operate at optimum level. So, perfect competition is an ideal market structure.
మన ఈ ఉన్నత విద్య కార్యక్రమాలపై మీ సందేహాలను సలహాలను అభిప్రాయాలను మాకు తెలియచేయండి. చిరునామా: డైరెక్టర్, ఆడియో విజువల్ ప్రొడక్షన్ అండ్ రీసెర్చ్ సెంటర్, డాక్టర్ బిఆర్ అంబేద్కర్ ఓపెన్ యూనివర్సిటీ, ప్రొఫెసర్ జి రామరెడ్డి మార్గ్, రోడ్డు నంబర్ 46, జూబ్లీ హిల్స్, హైదరాబాద్ 500033.